Hey gang, Asylum Child here. Today, I'm going to show you guys a tutorial about wings. Now, there's different kinds of wings that you can do in fantasy art and everything. We've got demon wings, we've got dragon wings, fairy wings, angel wings, feathers, skin, bugs, and mechanical if you do anime and stuff. So what we're going to do here is we're going to show about how to do some basic wings and stuff, and give you guys a little quick tutorial about different wings and how to do them. So let's see, we'll start off with the easiest first, the easiest being bat wings. Show you what I mean here. Bat wings consist of, as you can see in this picture here, it's kind of like a long arm with really long fingers. Just the same as an arm. The reason why you can see it so well is because it is just stretched out skin as opposed to having feathers. Even in fantasy art like here, like the 3D art and everything, you see you can have some extra limbs, or you could just stick with the whole finger motif as most realistic bats and stuff do. Something else you want to notice, this recreation here will illustrate this in this picture here. The skin is stretched out much like a parachute. It's stretched out here at the top, above the arm to the thumb, and between all of the fingers. So, something to keep in mind also, the coloring and the way that it's going to work too. It almost looks like leather because, well, leather is skin. And it stretches out, so it's going to be like of a pink color, depending on what color the bat is, even like this one. You'll notice it thins out a lot more and gets thicker as it goes along closer to the fingers. So we're going to illustrate this when we draw them. Also keep in mind of how, barbecue wings, how wings look when they're in flight, or stretched out, and how they look when they're folded. Like this illustration here. Notice that it folds just like closing your hand, and the wings fold accordingly. Like on this illustration too from Diablo. Okay, so let's get started. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a basic pencil sketch first, because we always want to do that. So, what you want to think of is say we got our figure here. I'm going to just draw a quick figure here. Say we got our figure here, and just quick figure. And they got shoulder and back like this. Okay. Now, your wings would come from your back socket here. So when you get your shoulder here, like this is your biceps and triceps and traps and all that. And then you get your shoulder blade here. And then the rest of your back, like your spine, and the back of your neck here, where you would have your figure's neck here. So your wing would come out about right here. And it's the same shape as the arm. So just think of it as an extra arm. So we're going to do it kind of semi-folded. So it would come out like this, just like a armpit and a tricep. And another muscle underneath. Then you would do it up here like a bicep and like a tricep, and then of course you got your elbow, and then it would bend about here. So you would go out like this, like a forearm. Then we get into the good part. So now it's, remember, it's kind of like a hand. So you put a little hand, but not too big. You got a thumb. I'm going to go off the edge of my picture here. It was a little longer than I thought. You got a thumb, and then That'll be clawed, probably. So it's cool to have bat wings with claws. Depending on how much you want this to be, you could even put extra claws and extra spinatures here, so that it looks, you know, they're really, you know, if they're really fierce demons or dragons or something, you can put extra spikes here on each of these parts, you know. Not on the elbow, because remember, the wings come out from this part. So, there's a membrane, like we saw. There's a membrane that goes from here. And you can skip this one if you want to. It's your preference. There's a thin membrane here that stretches between this top part. Like I said, you can skip that part if it doesn't go well with your spikes and stuff, but I'm just going to put it in there to illustrate. And then you put in your fingers like you would your hand. Okay, so it's got a kind of a hand. And then we got fingers. And just like your fingers, it's got different lengths. So, like, this would be the index finger. Like so. Once again, long claws if you want claws. Your middle finger is going to be longer. So, you do like this. The middle finger is going to be longer. Okay, like that. You got your third finger, a little bit shorter. Depending on how many you want, you can stick with three if you want. Or you can put in a last one, which is like just your little finger. You can actually add as many as you want. If you only want three, you could have three spread out. But the main part is they're spread out when it's unfolded. We're doing a half fold here. So you can have it as many of them as you want, just depending on the kind of wings you're trying to do. So don't worry about knuckles or anything, because they're really not really concerned about knuckles and things. The main thing is you want this. So there's a membrane, and remember, this is his or her back. Say her, because I mostly do females, huh? Okay, so the membrane would be about here on the bottom part of a shoulder blade. Okay? Actually, that's not her back at all. That's her back right here. Sorry. Okay, anyway, so it would start about right here. And you want to keep in mind about perspective, about how much the skin is stretching. And it kind of bows in a bit and goes toward the claw here. Close. Oh boy. I'm glad you guys put up with my stuttering, because I'm not used to public speaking, and even though this is being recorded, it's still kind of public speaking, so just bear with my stuttering. So kind of go like this. Same thing with here. You start about here. Just do like a good arch up here. And just come down. Kind of a good arch and come down, and then this is stretched out like this. So yeah, that's a good basic outline. That's a good basic outline. The thing to remember too is there's this one, but there's also two. There's two wings. So suppose we put another wing back here, and it's folded up more. So about the same basic shape as you got here. And then for folded wings, you want to go in more. We'll just go behind the wing here. And it kind of folds in like this. This part is actually, it looks thicker from the outside. So you want to do this and kind of make a triangle. Now, if you're doubtful about this, use references. Believe me, Google and stuff has lots of images that you can use references. And every artist will tell you that references are your friend. So, mostly like this. And then if you want to, you can even put in the fingers here like this. Just an outline of the fingers, as opposed to how it's folded in, see? And it's going to be, you know, real thick. You're not going to be able to see all the skin because it's folded. So, when you get it outlined like this, there's different lengths. So, like this, real short thing like this. If it's folded in, it's going to be like this, almost like a cloak. So, and you're not going to see all the fingers because it's folded into their back, like this. Here's your shoulder. And that's your back and your neck, like so. So like that, and then you've got the semi open like this, like what we're doing up here, and you go fully outstretched wing would be like, you know, you got it like this, and then you really got it out there like that, you know, then it'll be really fully outstretched like that. And get your fingers like that. So it depends on how you want your bat wing to be. So that's, always look at references so you can see how it folds and everything. So we got our basic outline here now. So what you want to start off with is you want to start off with a good vermilion. And I'll tell you why. Is because skin has blood flow. And a really good dramatic way to do that blood flow is to start off with a vermilion color so that you can really get that blood flow imagery in there for the skin. Remember, bat wings and dragon wings, demon wings, what have you, they are stretched skin over bones and flesh. So no feathers, no fur. I mean, you want fur wings. Oh. If you want fur wings, you know, that's your prerogative, but, you know, it's just, that's, and it doesn't normally have, fur on them. I kind of messed up here, so, kind of trying to recapture what we messed up here. Because, yeah, had to mess up the... Okay, there. Sorry. Okay. So we want to... That's a pencil in the mouth. What you want to start off with is a good vermilion color. Let's put it underneath the sketch so we can see it. Turn down the opacity of the sketch so that we don't have lines just everywhere. We just got reference. Okay. So you want to start with a good vermilion color, like this. And then you start on with the dark colors. Now, wings do not have to be the same color as your model. Okay? say your model is a, you know, this flesh color like this. Where's my... Oh. Say that she's a flesh color like this. You know, we got a... This model is like this color. Suppose she's like this color. She doesn't, you know, your wings don't have to be the same color. They don't have to be the same color. In fact, they'd probably be a little darker because of thicker skin and stuff. But if you want to, you can have it the same. You can have it the same color. So you start off darker color, just like you would. Or, you know, you start off with a good mid-tone color, like you would when you're painting flesh. Make sure we get this thing. Okay, good. So, yeah, and then you just start painting in the highlights, just like you would an arm. So keep in mind where your shades are, where your muscles are, where the bends in your arms are and stuff, and treat it just like you would an arm when you paint it. It can be a little tricky with the fingers, because fingers are tricky. But yeah, you just make sure that you have it the same way as you would an arm. You know, a little trickier with the fingers, but, you know, just treat it like you would if you were painting fingers. So knuckles have good highlights in there. Normally, they don't have more than about two knuckles. So you got like a knuckle here where it connects to the hand, and then it goes down. And then about halfway, about like here, you're going to have another knuckle, so you do it a little bit darker. And then about here, just like fingers. I know I keep saying that because it'll embed in your brain, and you'll be just like fingers when you paint your own. That's what you'll be thinking. You know, just like fingers, you know. Some of the longer fingers, if you want, you can even put more of them. More knuckles in there. Just don't make them like super duper unless that's the style you're going for. You want really ugly wings instead of elegant wings, then by all means put a bunch of knuckles in there, because, yeah, make it look weird and freakish if you're doing something horrid. But if you want just a succubus or a dragon or something that you want long, beautiful, elegant wings, don't put a bunch of knuckles. Remember, it's skin, so processing. So make sure that you don't put any harsh highlights, because skin. So unless you want it to be shiny, but that's, you know, once again, I'm not going for a shiny look here. I'm trying to just draw this skin like this. So. It's really tough to do on the fingers here because, well, they're so thin. So you might want to, if you don't trust your thin drawing skills here, you know, to really get those lines in, you can always section it off using your lasso tool if you really need to. Nobody's gonna judge you about that. Sometimes I gotta do that too. I gotta use a lasso tool to get in there and get real details. But now we're not doing too many on this because we're having the light source brung in here, and it's just kind of barely hitting these areas here, so you don't have to worry about that. Now, when it comes to this part here, we're going to, you get in there and you get the shadows. You know, you're getting shadows real good and everything. And remember that it's darker around the fingers. So what we're really going for is have it thick up here and around the edges of your arm. I say that with quotations, even though you can't see quotations. The arm. And then it thins out. Now if you want to, like I said, if you don't trust your pencil skills, what you can do is you can go around and pick just here inside the triangles, for more or less better word for it, triangles. And what you do is then you can start off thick round each of the lines like this. You can actually go smaller color first. Yep. Like this. It gets darker up at the top and thinner as you go out to the bottom. And then you put in the really good hard shadows. Like so. And you want to do that with each of the little triangles that we're doing here. So just hurry, do each one of these. Happy little wings. So like that. Say, why don't you do, block off all of the triangles all at once, and then, well, you can do that, but I tend to be a little messy with my airbrush, and I don't want to overspray into the other wings, if that makes sense. I don't want overspray getting onto this side just because I'm painting on this side. So, you want to keep it. You're going to keep it uniform, then you want to keep you can just do one at a time. It won't kill you just to do one at a time, And if it does, well, then I'm sorry, you can just explain to God. Well, I was watching Asylum Child's art videos, and he said it wouldn't kill me, and, well, it did, and here I am, and, I'll deal with God later if, it does kill you, so. Remember about where your shadows are and how much is going in there. So remember that these are rounded like that. I'm actually kind of rushing this, so when you do this, don't rush it. Don't say, oh, this is easy, and just do it, because patience is a virtue. And it's a good virtue to have patience. Patience! It's not just for Jedis. Now, the fun thing about wings is, like your ears, or anywhere it's got thin membranes and stuff, when you got light coming from behind your source, you're going to have a bright pink. So I will show you that too, just in case, you know, so you won't, so you'll be like, oh, you know, when you show how it goes when you do that. If you have a light source behind them, like say they're standing and there's fire behind them or something, and you want to illustrate that fire behind them, what you do is you take this, make it even brighter, and just real lightly highlight in the wing like this. What this does is it shows that there's a light source behind without taking away from the shadows and stuff inside the wing. You might want to even, you know, just really blend it out. And that way, it looks a lot better when it's darker. Matter of fact, let's make this darker, and then I'll show you. So duplicate layer, and then, you know, we'll turn it down real quick. Oh wait, not that. Yeah. Brightness. And then clip it down to the, yeah. Okay, so say it's real dark, you want a silhouette and everything, then you just go in here like this and then erase, which, oh, not with that. Sorry. Soft, not hard. And you just real lightly erase like this. And it shows like light coming through it. I was going to show this on my other tutorial too, where you can the lighting effects. And then you just do this on the outside, around the outside, around the outside. And just really show off that muscle and stuff. See, now it looks kind of silhouetted, and it looks like, you know, your light source is coming behind like that. And something else you can do too, while we're on the subject, you know, since there's going to be light shining through it, and because it's a membrane, you can take this color here, something kind of dark but not too dark, and you just come in with real lightly, a real small brush. Oh, have to go on the top layer, sorry. Top layer like this. And you just draw in. Well, you know what? Here. My goodness. Okay. And combine it down, because, okay, when you combine it down, that way you can paint on it. Because I was like, why is it not painting on it? Make sure you combine your layers once you got that down and everything. And then, like, what you do is you just, you know, go in here. I was using an eraser. Oh, boy. And just real lightly. Ugh, that's too dark. See, you don't want it too dark. Same like back here. Just real lightly. Put in some veins. And I mean like real lightly. You can just spray it real lightly. Put in veins like that. Now if that looks like crap and you're like, that looks like crap, then well, you know. Pick a different color. Something that's shadowy, but not too shadowy. Like, you know, like maybe this color here. And just kind of extend shadowy colors to be veins like that, where they disappear off into the shadow, you know. Like that. Ta-da! You can even leave those off if you want. And if they're too dark, you know, like that's still too dark, well then pick this light color and just go over them real good like that. Kinda blend them all back into the skin, you know. Like that. That way you still have veins, but they're just barely seen. And it gives it more realistic look, you know. And you say, well, that's great. What about the folded wings? Well, the folded wings are going to be the same color as back here. Just block it off real quick. Folded wings are going to be the same color as what we painted the wings, but they're going to be darker because they're silhouetted back behind our other wings here. So, yeah, I need to grab this other part down here. Hold on. Okay, so be like this color here, the really dark, shadowy color. Like this. And then you just bring in some highlights, you know. If you want, you can even put this wing on a separate layer so that it won't interfere with this one. Right now, I'm just using it for this. Remember, there's light over here. Oh, processing. Sorry. Okay. Remember, it's silhouetted, so there's not much to it. And you just kind of sure you sit in this, you know. It's folded like that. It'll make a lighter color for the highlight, the harsh light. Over here. Like that. There you go. And that's how you would do that. And the reason why it's darker is because the skin will get thicker. It's not so stretched out when the wing is closed. So when it's closed like this, it's, you know, thicker skin, it's going to be darker, and you won't have to do this light thin membrane and everything. You won't have to do that. So that's how you do bat wings. Okay, do not save. Okay, next up, let's do angel wings. Okay. Now, feathered wings are different. Let's go back to Google here. Feathers are interesting because feathers are kind of like hair. Okay, even when you paint them like this guy did, you can tell they have fibers to them and everything. This is painted, so you can make them look as rough or as smooth as you want. Like this guy does angels and stuff. He does some really rough feathers, you know. But if you look at real birds, like these, this is a real dramatic lighting, which I don't even know if I could do all that. That's if you have a, like we did with the bat wings, you have a light source behind. They're going to shine through the feathers. And I can show you guys how to do this effect too if you want. But my main focus was to tell you, like, looking at real feathers. So this is dark, so you can really get in there, okay? So wings for birds have three distinct parts. You got the shoulder joint here, like this connect to your shoulder, and you got this small part here. This is where the bones of the feathers are. They're actually just kind of right here, okay? Then you've got these medium length feathers here that come off of these, and then you got these long feathers here. The feathers consist of this long stem, and then various, you can have them smooth or you can have them rough, but they have this kind of shape, this kind of pointed shape. Same thing with these are stork feathers. Depending on what kind of feathers you want long, thin feathers, they get long and thin. Or if you get short feathers, they have the same shape, just, you know, different kinds of feathers. So depending on the kind of angel or winged creature you're doing will depend on how you do this. So okay, let's once again draw in our figure real quick. Okay, so we got, okay, figure here. Okay, so this is her arm, bicep, tricep, elbow, forearm. You got your shoulder blade, which is attached here, neck, spine, and shoulder, okay? So, just like we did before, same thing. Okay, so you got basic outline of our figure now. Now, what we're going to do here is, like, once again, going to make a stretched out wing, and then we'll make a folded wing behind that. So, same kind of structure as what we had with the bat wing. So you got your bicep, you got your shoulder here, sort of. You got your thing and your bicep and the shoulder, and then it goes only out to about right here. But then it stops, so basic outline is like this. And it's got little feathers here, so, you know, kind of stretch out. So, little feathers here. Because there's only so much bone here. If you've ever eaten a chicken wing, you know what I'm talking about. It goes out to the elbow, and then the bone just kind of stops back here. You know, it's mostly just this shape. It's mostly just this shape right here is what you got. This is the bone part right here. You got these short little feathers here. And you're going to have these medium feathers here. They're kind of spear-shaped like this, see? So medium feathers here, like this. And then you got this fan of long feathers that may or may not be separated, like this. So, like that, and then they go shorter here. So, basic shape outline here. You got this here, then this basic shape right here, and then it goes out to a medium shape. It goes basic shape like this, and then this long shape, you got it like here, like this shape here, and then it cuts off into a smaller fan back here. When folded, and we'll do the folded wing back here, it goes like this. And then this, and then it folds down. And you can see these feathers here, like this, kind of in a perspective thing. And then these are folded in like this. Like that. Okay? I don't know if you can see it. Maybe I should have put that on a different layer. But I guess you can see it, so it's fine. Okay. Alright, so now here's how you paint feathers. Alright, so let's go here. Let's make this layer here. Okay, so depending on how dark, if you want black feathers or you want gray feathers or white feathers, it doesn't matter. Color scheme, same thing. Dirty wings, clean wings. You want tattered wings? Do you want smooth wings, like did this angelic creature just get out of a battle, or are they just chilling out in heaven somewhere? That's up to you. What we're going to do is we're going to go with this. I'm going to go with this blue color. This got a bluish gray. Okay. We use our lasso tool and just capture our wing shape real quick. Oh, dang it. All right, let's try that again. Lasso tool can be such a pain in the butt. All right. Ah, I did it again. Okay, I'm just going to add to it. Hopefully you're better at the lasso tool than I am, because, oh my god, I must be just completely horrible. God dang it. Okay, now we're just getting bad. Alright, here, we're just... basic outline of shapes here. If it's gonna be difficult, then I'm just gonna do this. Okay. Hopefully your outline is going to be a lot better than that, because mine was just, you know, I got tired of fighting with it, you know? So forgive me for my impatience. I just, yeah. Okay. So then we're going to fill that in with this bluish gray color, like this. Okay, basic outline there. Okay. Once again, your angel is this color. You know, it doesn't matter if she's this color or not. You just, you know. We're not doing with skin, so it doesn't matter if they're the same color or not, because angels, you know, they can have whatever skin color angels have. Most of the time they're pictured as white or something, so, you know, real pale or whatever, but depending on whatever angel you need, that's your business. So, alright, we're gonna clip that and go back to our color here. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to gradually just like go up. And what you want to do is you want to make quick strokes like this. Just like you would hair. Because that's pretty much what feathers are. It's just like fur. So you want to just quick strokes like this. And you go from bottom to top. And the reason why is because there's shadows up here. Okay? Shadows are coming from underneath each of these individual feathers, and the light is going to hit them at their tips. At their tips here. So to illustrate this, you want to do like this. And you just get a right length and just go like that. Kind of like, just like you would hair. So you get basic outline, just like you would hair or fur. Make sure you get in there and each individual being like this, just where you got each individual feather, pretty much. We're going into individual feathers instead of clusters of feathers. Then you want your strokes to be solid and strong going in there, like so. So make sure, get your solid and strong and just, you know, all the way in there. Okay? These especially, because these are your main feathers right here. So you want these main feathers like this. Okay. So all the way from the edge, fading into shadow. When I turn it right side up again, you see what I mean? And that's a good basic outline for them. And you just go lighter and lighter. Make sure you get in there and you just lighter and lighter like this. Edges of these wings like this. You can do the edges of these feathers each like this. These are thicker than hair, so you can't really do like a mass like you would with hair. You could kind of cheat with hair and kind of do a mass, but with feathers, not so much. You can't really do that. Also remember that feathers are two-sided. So you want the light showing on the brightest side, like so. So we're just kind of one-siding all these feathers here, like this. Also remember perspective, meaning this side of the feather is facing you, so it's going to be a little bit thicker than the... Oh, now I'm just getting terrible. Okay, I got my hands in a weird position or something, okay? Remember that this side of the feather is going to be thicker than this side, so it's going to be a thinner... As you go down the feathers, change your brush size accordingly so that it doesn't like that. For these. Thinner side. Like that. And that's basic. Then you kind of want to real lightly go over like an edge here. Real lightly, not, you know, just kind of blur out like that a bit. On the ends, because they thin out as I stretch out. So like that. Take the sketch off. See? If you really want to get into it and make even more detail, even go up a higher, go real small, and draw in the processing, sorry, okay. Draw in the stems. Like that. If you want to do that. Also, if you want to make them kind of tattered, it's okay to have, you know, some like that. You know, just kind of going out a bit. Can't really see it because of the sketch, so I'll just do this. But you, kind of use real thin lines and kind of tatter it out a bit, you know, you can do that. See, makes it look a little tattered. Back here, you want to take this darker color. Well, back to where we were. And kind of blur in a shadow. Like this. That way it gives it depth to our angel here. See, do that. Like that. And that'll give it more depth and everything. If you want to do it into really, really a lot of detail, even more so, said you can go into a higher color, the higher color, which is almost blue, like a blue, real pale blue. And get like a, you know, like your hair brush, if you have a hair texture brush. Go up here to these bigger feathers, and some of the feathers that are closer to the edge of where your light's at. And just start, like you can actually kind of paint in kind of the strata. Like that. And that'll give it a kind of a nice effect, just randomly. Do like this, like you would fur or hair. Make sure you're going in this motion though, because feathers grow this way. So you want to make sure that you got, yeah, got it in the correct motion. Otherwise, it's going to look weird. And it won't look uniform. Feathers are uniform. Much like, a lot like fur. But see? So you can do that. Do like this and just bring out some of the strands of the feathers to make them really stand out, you know? Like that. For our other wing, let's do this real quick. Oh, I'm gonna put this on another layer. Yeah, just because. Other layer, we just, you know. Then you just do your normal layer brushing. Just the same as you did for this one. Go around the edge. And make sure you go around the edges and like this. It's silhouetted, so not going to be a whole lot to it. So, you know. And just where the light would hit them. Like that. Make sure you shadow in, you know, real dark, where in between, right where it's going to silhouette, where the other wing is over. So, yep. Make sure you get in between feathers here to really show some depth. Maybe add some shadows inside like this. There you go. And that's how you do angel's wings. Now you can change the color, of course, if you want. You can change the color to any color, really, depending on what you want to do here. Like I can correction layer, you know, hue and saturation. You can make them real light, real dark blue. Turn it down even darker, like we did with the demon wings. And then, you know, erase what you don't want. So, you know, go up here. Goodness sakes, okay. And then, oh, hold on. I'm stuck, hold on. Make sure if you're going to do this, that you use this little clip at layer below. That way it doesn't affect, you know, your other stuff. So, yeah. See. Yeah. Dramatic lighting is like that, you know. Ta-da. There you go. That way you can have it even darker or lighter depending on how you want them with your effects and things, you know. Now for the light effects, like we were talking about earlier, and I'm gonna combine that. And what you do is you take the bright color, and you just go in between the feathers like this. Well, not with an eraser, because that'll erase it. Okay, like this. Just make it real bright in between, around the edges and in between, like so. And just like we would with any dramatic lighting, and it kind of washes it out at the end, just like hair. We do dramatic lighting with hair. See, like that. Ta-da! That's how you do that. And that's how we do angel wings. Okay. Next up, let's do some fairy wings. Okay, so butterflies are a little different. So let's look at insect wings. Insect wings consist of patterns like so. In fact, it's going to be almost iridescent. Same thing as like bat wings, only instead of flesh you got exoskeleton. Now the thing about these are, like moth wings and stuff like that, is going to be different. These are more like grasshopper, wasps, stuff like that. Butterflies, on the other hand, I don't know if you can see this. Probably can't. That's a small illustration, isn't it? Okay, let's look at butterfly wings. Okay, so those are insect wings. But if you look at butterfly wings, notice, like monarch butterflies and stuff, they got the same kind of patterns as insects have. Like, it's more like veins as opposed to feathers or the skin stretched out. They have more of a membrane and more veiny kind of structures. So, once again, draw our figure. Okay, so this time we draw our figure. Okay. Shoulder. And you got a shoulder blade. There, shoulder here, neck muscles here, and shoulders and back. Okay, so here we go. Alright, so for a butterfly wing, like we want to do, let's see, just insect wing. So they have a basic shape that just, they're never folded. If they do fold, okay, let's do the folded one first. Okay, so if they do fold, they would just go straight out back like this. Like a cloak almost. Like this. So they'd be folded on her back like that. But if you have it out and everything, it's just, you got basic shapes like this. And depending on what kind of basic shape you want, they're going to be like this, and then they'll have a secondary one like about here, like that. Now these can actually be any shape you want. In fact, you can make them as dramatic as you want, like so. So I'm going to make this as dramatic as can be, just like so. Mm-hmm. Now, the difference between insect wings and, like, other wings would be, like, you got your exoskeleton membrane. And it's more like veins instead of feathers or fingers. So it's kind of these awesome geometric patterns. So, I know math. Math is not my forte either. So you want to do some thick lines. And, you know, really thicken out corners. Like this. And then thicken out this corner here. Like so. Kind of like eyelashes. You know how we draw in our eyelashes and we have thick parts at the ends and stuff? It's like that. So this is thick here, this is thick here. And then we'll do a thin, and then a thick membrane here, or a thick part here, like so. Okay. And then you just do these cool patterns, like you just, like this. If you want, you can just do, like, basic lines, like you got, start in with thick lines. Like so. Just kind of round stuff out, you know, like this. Once again, if you are not sure about stuff from memory, you know, use references. References are your friend. So, but you can go as crazy as you want, you know. You want just round patterns, you know, and just simple round patterns or something, then that's up to you, you know. It's just whatever you want. So once you get the, you know, your pattern down that you want and everything, then comes the fun part. So what you want to do is you want to keep the black on there because that's what they're made out of. And you want to try and put color in behind the little pattern here. It's kind of like a stained glass, really. It's pretty much what it reminds me of, at least, is stained glass. So a lot of these wings and things are just like stained glass. In fact, you know, you can have stained glass patterns, you know. You want to put stained glass patterns in them, that's even better. That's a better illustration and everything. So, yeah, you want to make sure kind of like tribal art tattoos or something that you get real thick corners. All of them have thick corners. Like monarchs and stuff, they have thick corners. So just make sure all your corners are rounded off and thick, you know, like this. Kind of like a spider web. It's easier if you do beetle wings or something, but I'm just doing random patterns. Like so. Let's see. Gives it an insectoid feel to it, which is exactly what we want, because, well, it is insectoid. So, round off any corners that you got, like so. This could take a while, you know? Okay. Because it's like, dude, you're just, you know, how long are you going to sit there and round off corners? Something like that. There you go. Okay. Now, that's not exactly the way it is, but, you know, monarch butterflies and stuff. But like I said, you know, you can use references for yours if you want. Okay, so we go behind. We're going to go behind our pattern here. A little sloppy there, but, you know, whatever. Okay. That's why we have these. Okay. Do-do-do. Do-do-do. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so then we got that. We'll go with let's go with some bright colors. So we'll start off with a green. Okay, so we do this mint green color. That'd be cool. Mint green's cool. Okay. All right, hold that in place. And then we'll play around with it. You'll add colors like. Add some light blue in here, so we'll go up here and go around. What you want to do is you want to go in each of the panes of the stained glass and kind of make light come through them as best you can. Just in the middle part. There you go. Like that. If you want to get real fancy, you can do all kinds of stuff. Like you can add color, just to your preferences to, you know, add color to the ends here. Like that. A little orange or something in the back part here. Yeah. Like that, you know. But the main thing is you want it to look like kind of like stained glass. And then when you really get happy with it, then you can do the almost white highlights. Like so. Because insect wings, unlike the other we were talking about, are actually shiny. So you want to add a little bit of shine to each and every section you got here. That way, It looks like insectoid. There you go. Down here. Different picture. Down here on this wing that's folded up. Go back to our blue color here. Make it dark. You know, you can lighten it up some. You want to keep in mind that it's down here and it's folded, so you don't want to use as much as you did there, you know. Like this orange would be darker. Yeah. Like so. The yellow wouldn't be so yellow, would be, you know, like that. And then when you do highlights, you just do on the very edge, like on the edge ones, because they're the only ones like showing, like that, where the light source is coming. You also want to make sure that you get nice deep shadows in there, so, oop, my bad. Nice deep shadows in there, like this, so. Matter of fact, I can just go like that. And like so. Yep. And that's fairy wings. Fairy wings are pretty self-explanatory. Even with this, like, random pattern like that, it's still, that's still what you do. And if you do light, in front of them, let's combine here, okay? If you do light behind them and everything, correctional layer, you know, turn it down, and then eraser. Make sure you get into each of the parts like this, you know, with the light behind it. If you're doing like a silhouette, make sure you get each individual, because you can see through it. So you just kind of, and then, oh, my bad, we didn't do our clipping. Okay, like, oh, processing one. Okay, like that. And then make sure you just get it inside like it was, like it's lit up from the opposite side, like stained glass. And there you go. That's fairy wings. So, mechanical wings are different because we're talking about metal parts. So what you want to do is you want to do the same thing you got with our other wings. So you know, when you get our illustration here, when you you got your figure and you shoulder blades. So critical of myself, man. Okay. Alright, so, like, you get into here and you do this. This is, our back shoulder. Okay, so for, like mechanical wings, it's the same, basic outline as your normal wings. Like, they're gonna be connected through a harness, or, you know, maybe they're cybernetic or something like that, so we'll, you know, they're wearing a harness or something like that. And then you got the same basic outline as a wing like this, you know. And then instead of feathers or whatever, you're going to have, you know, mechanical parts. So maybe something like this. Invent. Maybe a seam here. Seam up here where it would fold. Like that. And then, like anime style, you got movable parts, so you'd have like sheaths like this, you know. And you can put patterns on these or whatever, like I'll put patterns. Kind of mostly doing it like Mercy's wings, you know, from Overwatch. She's got mechanical wings. It's always cool like that, but you want to, you know, just have some like that. And you can have like this, and then have like a seam like there, you know. Share preferences for mechanical stuff. You know, remember it. Stuff folds and things. So if you want, you know, seams and things, that's your prerogative. You know, you could even do, you know, patterns on here if you want. Like, my bad. Let's see. You have like. Like these, you know, pattern on them if you want, you know. Kind of give your little sci-fi pattern or something, you know. You can just do that and have sci-fi patterns on them. Anyways, what you do here is, you know, you can just have jetpack parts or something, you know, back here. It's something for propulsion or something, you know, and just whatever your preference is back here, you know, you could just do that. Jet propulsion. So, the way I do this is, like this. Then we'll get, like, this blue color. Oh, I've done this before. Some of you may remember it from some other painting things I did before. Oh. I have to... I'm just quickly going over the pattern, because I don't want this video to be too long. I just wanted to do some stuff. So, okay. Like that. And then, like, just like you would metal, because it's metal, so you can shine it up some, you know, just however you got it here, you know, like this. Do 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 do, like around the vents and here around these, you know. You just do like you would metal parts, and you get your metal parts like this. All your metal parts like this. It's got the same, you know, same structure, just mechanical. So everything's got harsh lines, and you know, except for the main part, and then you got your highlights, because it's metal. You want, you know, contrasting highlights like this to where it shows like it's really shiny, you know. Like that, like so. Yep. So you just go over each of the parts and like real shine to them, you know. Like this. Okay. Like that, so it looks like metal, you know. And then a cool thing, like if you want Mercy's, like kind of Mercy's wings and stuff. So we'll go back behind here and go back here and do like this. And you do like this little knife pattern like this, and we'll just add to it like this. Keeping in mind about the wings pattern like this, you know. And then what you could do is a little like orange. Like yellow, really bright yellow. Oh, sorry. Like, yeah, I could use a gradient, but I don't want to. It's more fun to like this, and then psh, like that. All right, mercy wings. If you want, you can even go even brighter. Okay. Like that. Keep moving the... Like that, you know. Just really get in a gradient, you know. And then, like, you could even, like, invert. And, yeah, go on the outside here. And then, you know, make it look like lasers, you know. And that's how you do, that's how you do mechanical wings. Mechanical wings the same way as real wings. You're just, you know, you're just, putting in mechanical parts. And you can put in colors and stuff, you know, you can put in their colors and everything, you know, just depending on what you want. They got color and red parts and stuff and seams and things. If you want glowing things like lights or something, like, so we want these to glow red, you just make a wider brush and just go around like that, and just make them like that, right in the middle, like that, and it makes them glow. Just make it lighter, like color, and then, like, you know, make it really, really white on the inside, like a lightsaber, like that, you know. Like that, and then it's glowing red. And that's how you do that. Well, I mean, it's been a good long tutorial, but I hope you guys learned some things, and I hope it improves your artwork when it comes to drawing wings and things. As you can tell, it just takes a little practice, and always use references. Like I said, Google Images has tons of references, like we discovered and everything. So until next time, thanks for watching.